Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
At that time, the Lord appointed 72 others and sent them on ahead, 2 by 2, into every town and place where he himself was about to go. And he said to them, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, pray earnestly to the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest. Go your way. Behold, I am sending you out as lambs in the midst of wolves. Carry no bag, no haversack, no knapsack, no sandal. Greet no one on the road. Whatever house you enter, first say, 'Peace to this house.' And if a son of peace is there, your peace will rest upon him. But if not, it will return to you. And remain in the same house, eating and drinking what they provide, for the laborer deserves his wages. Do not go from house to house. Whenever you enter a town and they receive you, eat what is set before you. Heal the sick in it and say to them, 'The kingdom of God has come near to you.' But whenever you enter a town and they do not receive you, go into its streets and say, 'Even the dust of your town that clings to our feet, we wipe off against you.' Nevertheless, know this, that the kingdom of God has come near. I tell you, it will be more bearable on that day for Sodom than for that town. Woe to you, Chorazin! Woe to you, Bethsaida! For if the mighty works done in you had been done in Tyre and Sidon, they would have repented a long time ago, sitting in sackcloth and ashes. But it will be more bearable in the judgment for Tyre and Sidon than for you. And you, Capernaum, will you be exalted to heaven? You shall be brought down to Hades. The one who hears you hears me, and the one who rejects you rejects me, and the one who rejects me rejects him who sent me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Our text is from Luke chapter 10, verse 1 to 16, but much of what I'm going to say today is more catechetical. Please be seated. So, my dear sisters and brothers, today we celebrate the great solemnity of St. Francis Xavier, and I think Goa is ecstatic on a day like this. They are extremely happy. It's just another day, another different kind of day. I think Christmas is also overshadowed sometimes in Goa by the great feast of St. Francis Xavier. St. Francis Xavier was one of St. Ignatius of Loyola's closest friends, and originally the founding companion of what we know today as the Society of Jesus, or the Jesuit order as we know it today. He's known, among other things, for his missionary accomplishment, particularly in India, in Southeast Asia, in Japan. He was born in the year 1506 in a family castle in the Basque region of northern Spain, and he was the fifth of and the youngest child of very noble, very wealthy and pious parents. Of course, as I will tell you, they died, his father died when he was already extremely young. Now, already at the age of 19 years and after completing his preliminary course of studies, Francis Xavier left home permanently at the age of 19. He was bound for the University of Paris. And by the age of 30,
he had already earned a master's degree in art, in arts and philosophy. He also taught the subject later on for 4 years and then studied theology for another 2 years. Now, while studying at the university, Ignatius Loyola, who was also a fellow student, became an increasingly important influence in the life of St. Francis Xavier. So much so that despite his early reluctance, Xavier eventually did the spiritual exercises under the direction of St. Ignatius himself. And then in August of 1534, he joined St. Ignatius and 5 other companions in pronouncing their vows together. Now, together, Xavier and Ignatius were ordained priests in the year 1537. And in the following year, Xavier went to Rome to share in the discussions that led to the formal founding of the Society of Jesus. Upon approval, St. Francis Xavier became the secretary of the society till he left for India in the year 1541. Now, St. Francis Xavier's missionary travels took him to many places around the world. In fact, Xavier was the only original companion to, among those who joined with St. Ignatius, to ever leave Europe. He traveled from Rome to Lisbon in Portugal and then to India. And along the way, he assisted in many previously established missions, including, as we know now, those in Mozambique, in Kenya, also off the island of Somalia, finally to Goa, and various communities in the coastal regions of India. And then in 1549, St. Francis Xavier began the first Christian mission in Japan. I don't know whether many of you have even watched that movie, Silence. It's one of the most beautiful movies I've ever seen. And it is here that he served in that country for almost 2 years. He also knew of China, and so he set sail to begin the first Christian mission in China. But when he arrived, he was not allowed to disembark and enter into the mainland. And so he waited on a very small island of Canton while trying to gain entry into China. He finally died, as we know, of acute illness on that island at a very young age of 46 years. St. Xavier was canonized finally by Pope Gregory XV on March 12, 1622, at the same time that St. Ignatius of Loyola was also canonized. Now, Francis's mission was not just bound inside the church, but he was also a very compassionate shepherd who helped Christians, several of them who were being ill-treated by the Portuguese. Also, we are told that the neighboring Raja very often invaded that place and caused great suffering to the people. And he organized, therefore, many expeditions, relief expeditions to help people, as we've been doing in the pandemic, with food materials. And he went by boat to these small Christian communities who were in need of help. He also went across to provide Christian faith. We know from the life of St. Ignatius also that St. Ignatius and his companions set up several schools, so did St. Francis Xavier. He started a few schools to give education for the converts and their children. Now, St. Francis Xavier ranks among the greatest of the missionaries in Christian history. The numbers place the baptisms at 30,000. One record even said he went as well, many as 1 lakh people that he converted. 3 qualities of St. Francis Xavier are highlighted, which are very noteworthy and very useful even for us to reflect in our modern world, and I'd like to share with you. The first one is that St. Francis Xavier was a man of prayer. Now, we've heard this statement said very often, he was a man of prayer, but there are some saints that really stand out in the church, yeah, as men of tremendous prayer. The authors who wrote about his life have defined him as a man of not only prayer, but of intense prayer, of intense prayer. He used to spend long time in prayers, and often even at night time, after a very busy day of apostolate, you would find him in prayer. In fact, a witness once wrote about him, they said, during the day he entirely belonged to God, and during the night he also entirely belonged to God. The second thing that we notice about Saint Francis Xavier was he was a man of great enthusiasm, and I think we need that more than ever in these days of pandemic. We need people who are enthusiastic, lively, and I always look at sad people, and or rather sad looking people, and I say, can you please smile? Yeah, it's the simplest thing in life. Yeah, I know we have a bad day, or we have a bad hour, or we have bad moments in our life. But by and large, I think we need a lot of enthusiasm these days in our lives. And St. Francis Xavier was a man of enthusiasm. You know, he set high standards for himself and had very ambitious plans for the future. He was a man of quick perception and sound judgment. And while he was very fervent, he was also known to be a man who was very realistic with when it came to dealing with life and with facts. Yet his goals were not to be the best or to be first, but rather his goal was always to make an impact. Yeah, I think many of us in this world today, we strive to be the best. We want to be first. We want to be, we want people to acknowledge us. And sometimes we may make a big splash, as my dear friend Father Larry would say, a flash in the pan and nothing more than that. Or as he called it, he would say, the church often gets what we call the flavor of the season. He said one person comes and then everybody is calling him to all the churches, and then the next fellow comes as a flavor of the season. What impact have we made? You see, great saints impacted the lives of people. And when you also remember in your life, you will always realize that person, that teacher, that person. Yeah, especially teachers. Yeah, teachers can make or break you. Yeah, priests can make or break you. But you'll say, that person impacted my life. Yeah, they may have not stood out as great orators and very handsome people, but they impacted my life. They changed my life. And that's what St. Francis Xavier did. He was also known to have conducted his life's work with great vitality and with great zeal. Yeah, for instance, when Loyola asked Xavier, he said, would you like to go to an expedition to the Far East? Yeah, I think most people, if you say today, if you'd like to go to the missions of India, they look at you like, why am I being punished with this post, yeah, as a priest? They say of Francis Xavier, when he was asked in those days, would you like to go to the Far East? He was overjoyed. Yeah, he was actually overjoyed. So even the descriptions of how he moved capture his gusto. They said he walked with joyful, with a calm face, and everywhere he went with laughter in his mouth. St. Francis Xavier's enthusiasm is underscored when recognizing that his work and his life was not really easy. Yeah, none of the saints' lives were very easy. We sometimes think, oh, they were saints, they could do it. No. They went through a lot of difficulty. 17th and 16th century sea voyages all the way to the east were filled with life-threatening dangers. Moreover, by the time St. Francis Xavier finished his university studies, his father, his mother, and his sister had all died. His father, as I said earlier, had passed away when he was just 6 years old. And his other sister and brothers had married, and he felt lonely. He even used the word, he speaks of himself as an orphan. However, it was not only during this time that he felt this way. For much of his life, he struggled with the feelings of loneliness, of depression, and chronic feelings of inferiority, and yet he was enthusiastic. You see, yet he was enthusiastic because I guess he pushed himself, and that's why I said he was a man of zeal. Yeah, he pushed himself. And finally, he was a man, there was great openness to the influence of others, the third quality associated with Xavier's personality, including how he related to others as well as he related to himself. It goes beyond enthusiasm. It goes very often beyond passion. Xavier was known to be a very charismatic man. He had a very dashing and robust personality. And he has been described by several people by various words. astounding, cheerful, decisive, vivacious, practical, prudent, keen, ambitious boy even in school that he was. I think today, looking at a man with all these qualifications, we would say to ourselves, this chap is a people's person. Yeah, he really is a people's person. He was successful because of his ability to mix easily with persons of various social classes, races, beliefs. St. Francis Xavier understood people. He learned the language of, and he adopted the indigenous dress and the culture of people. Xavier, in that sense, lived the beginnings of what we call today enculturation. He had a deep sense of cross-cultural understanding and appreciated that God's presence was in all cultures, in all people, in all places, in all things. Something today we are finding it very hard in our country to accept. Yes, we always think God is an exclusive property of our religion or some other religion. No. Yeah, God works through every element, through every way possible in the lives of every culture, of every race, of every group. These three qualities of St. Francis Xavier are reflected in a description of him written by a companion. And this is what his companion said: "I have never met anyone more filled with faith and hope, more open-minded than Francis. He never seems to lose his great joy and enthusiasm. He talks to both the good and he talks to the bad. Anything he is asked to do, Francis does willingly, simply because he loves everyone." He loves everyone. I think we are all, my dear brothers and sisters, called to be missionaries. We may not be called to travel to some far-off land, but there are always those in our midst who need to hear the good news of Jesus Christ in our midst, in our city, in our area where we live. And remember, sometimes, not sometimes, always, it is how we act and what we do that speaks more profoundly for Christ than what we say. We may say all the alleluias we want in the world, and if, like St. Francis Xavier, as his colleagues described him, he loved everyone, if love is not an integral part of our life, then surely we have failed the Lord. I want to wish you a very happy feast, especially to the community of St. Francis Xavier in my parish, led by Alex Pacheco. Thank you, Alex, for all your love, for the service to your community, in spite of even the struggles that you and your family went through in this pandemic. You were always there. And I want to wish you and the entire community a very happy feast. God bless you. And also to the people of Dabul, from where my father hailed. My parents grew up in Dabul. I grew up going on the 3rd of December down that road for mass. But I think more than the mass, we went for the cardio video. And then we went for those little rusty bombs that you took and you banged on the ground. I think we cried and cried till our father gave us some of those, but those were happy memories. Dabul at one time was a great parish, alive. Today people have moved away, moved on. But till today, across the world, if you go and say, "I am from Dabul," I think you are embraced as a son. God bless you all, and happy feast to all our viewers in Goa.